Well, as a result, Ryan Bronson's time 49.06, Kovac 49.23. They're the two qualifiers from that fourth heat of this first round of the men's 400-meter hurdles.
And we can see John Ridgeon in the lineup for the next heat in lane one. Curt Young of Panama in two, Mashchenko of Russia in three, Marcel Schelbert of Switzerland in four, Tēbelis of Latvia in five, Cordero, then Winthrop Graham of Jamaica, and then Dollendorf of Belgium in lane eight. Great moment for John Ridgeon. He really wanted to make this Olympic team. But judging by the times that the other runners have achieved during these heats, he's going to certainly have to run a season's best, I would guess, to get into the first two, especially with the likes of Winthrop Graham around. Two fastest to the semi-finals as well. And a difficult draw in many ways. He's right on the inside. But John Ridgeon, a remarkable athlete, out of athletics for 2.5 years. And he said that he's really only ever had two problems in his running career, his right Achilles tendon and his left. He's had so many problems. This is Winthrop Graham, twice a medalist in World Championships and second in Barcelona behind Kevin Young. Dollendorf of Belgium there, that piece of strapping across his nose, supposed to help breathing. And there's another bit of strapping, slightly bigger this time, and that's on the left knee of Winthrop Graham. So John Ridgeon will be disappointed if he doesn't make it through here, but you know one thing, he's going to give it 110%. It's Ridgeon on the inside. Winthrop Graham out in lane seven. And we understand that he may have dislocated that knee a few weeks ago. If that's the case, it's very, very suspect. Well, John Ridgeon not hanging about. He's got Curt Young of Panama outside him. Winthrop Graham not out particularly quickly. Cordero is going off reasonably well. And John Ridgeon, well, he's got a bit of ground to make up on Curt Young of Panama. And Winthrop Graham, in fact, has gone. That was at about hurdle three. So that knee was suspect. But it's Curt Young. Oh, and Curt Young's gone. And thank goodness it didn't disrupt John Ridgeon's hurdling. Disappointing for Curt Young. He was going well. But into the home straight now, John Ridgeon. Just inside him, Mashchenko is okay. On the outside, Marc Dollendorf of Belgium, but it's John Ridgeon in the lead. This is going to be a good run from the Briton. John Ridgeon coming through into first place, 49.32. Dollendorf crashes to the ground, but he's safe in second place. A little bit of drama there, but it didn't affect John Ridgeon. Well, we're going to have a look at that again, but John Ridgeon there, he'll be delighted to go through to the semi-finals, and he deserved to with that run. He got it right, and it's big smiles all round. A former high hurdler, a brilliant junior. Very, very bad luck with injury, but he's back, and now we know he's back well. And we've heard that he felt very good indeed. It was windy out there this morning. We saw the flag blowing a little while ago, but John Ridgeon coming across the line comfortably. Dollendorf there and Mashchenko of Russia in third, but he's going to have to go and wait and see. The time, 49.32, not particularly quick. I'd be surprised if we got the fastest losers from this heat. But John Ridgeon just out of shot. We're watching Dollendorf at the moment, who went crashing to the ground. John just finishing there, and here goes Dollendorf. But we saw him walking off the track. He's okay. But great disappointment for Winthrop Graham, the silver medalist from 92. Now, Winthrop Graham is second from the right of your picture there. You can see the strapping on his left leg. Seems to be fairly comfortable there, although Cordero of Puerto Rico is coming up inside, and there he is. It wasn't the third hurdle at all. It was the first. It was all too much.
Well, Graham, of course, second in the World Championships in 1991, third in the World Championships in 93, and he was the Olympic silver medalist 4 years ago. That was his fate, and when you consider that Curt Young, Panama, he's got a best of 49.51. He went down. Not of character to get up and start again, but you've got no chance.
Well, let's have a look at John Ridgeon once again. While we're doing that, we can tell you that unofficially it's Kita and Yamazaki, the fastest losers. But Stuart, this guy really has come back extremely well. He's worked incredibly hard.
Well, for his size, to achieve the 13 stride pattern that he does down that back straight is quite remarkable. We always forget, you know, that way back in 1987 he got a silver medal in the World Championships in the high hurdles. He's a class athlete, he really is, and that sort of spirit experience takes him through. Lovely change, there's the incident next to him. That's the change down. He had to really motor, didn't he, for that one. And the high hurdler has to learn to alternate, that is to say, hurdle with the other leg leading at certain stages during the race, particularly in the final stages. It's quite difficult to do, particularly in there. You saw the alternate, two legs, different legs being used over the hurdle on those last two hurdles. A competent run, and I can tell you that it's very difficult from the inside lane. It's so tight that it makes life very difficult. He's lucky to have the left leg lead on that first bend.